नमस्कार। वजाइनल हेल्थ इज नॉट वेरी ऑफन डिस्कस्ड और टॉक्ड अबाउट, बट इट इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट फॉर वुमेन्स हेल्थ। इचिंग, एबनॉर्मल डिस्चार्ज, इरिटेशन एंड ईस्ट इन्फेक्शन, इवन बॉइल्स एंड पिंपल्स, दीज आर ऑल वेरी कॉमन प्रॉब्लम। ऑल दीज आर फ्यू इश्यूज दैट डेवलप इन वजाइनल एरिया। वजाइनल इश्यूज कैन कॉज irritation, discomfort, low self-esteem in life, and they are going to interfere with daily activities. So today we will discuss how to keep the vaginal area healthy. First and foremost is prevention. If you take steps to keep the vaginal area clean and healthy and dry, you can avoid the occurrence of lots of these problems. First preventive method is soaked in warm water. Vaginal boils are another very common problems occurring in that area, and oil glands and blocked hair follicles can cause pus filled lumps to form outside the vaginal area. So what could be the remedy? Do this regularly. Soak yourself in a bathtub or fill a tub with warm water and sit in that tub for some time. Warm water will clean the area thoroughly and help you to compress the boil. Second point, include yogurt in your diet. Probiotics can help to prevent infection like bacterial vaginosis. Yogurt is a natural source of probiotic that helps introducing healthy bacteria in your body. So have a bowl of dahi yogurt every day in your meal. Now this yogurt can be taken in a liquid form. Make a very thin buttermilk and drink glass full of buttermilk 3-4 times in a day when you have some problem. Otherwise, once in the afternoon at the time of lunch, a glass of buttermilk is enough. You can also apply yogurt in the vaginal area, basically when there is an infection of yeast in that area. Third point, change pads after regular interval. It is very important to change pads regularly. That area should always remain dry. Wetness in that area is going to cause infection, it's going to cause boils and pimples too. Wearing the pads for a very long duration is going to irritate the skin, bring skin rashes, and make skin sensitive for other infection. Along with curd, there is another thing, which is cranberry. Very important. Make it as a routine to eat every day when you are going through some trouble. When there is pus cell, when you pass urine, that also helps in removing that. Cranberry is another very effective food which you should include in your regular diet. Fourth point, wear comfortable clothing and your inner garments. Choose breathable fabrics. Ideally, cotton. Synthetic fibers such as nylon and other synthetic materials prevent the area from breathing. They trap heat and moisture and preventing that area from breathing freely. That creates a breathing ground for yeast infection. So, cotton is more breathable and absorbent, which makes it ideal for preventing yeast infection. Nowadays, ladies, girls, wearing such a tight clothing for a longer duration is going to cause problems. See, wearing tight clothes is not a problem. Only you should see that you switch between tight and loose and comfortable clothing alternatively, and that would keep you healthy. Or you can wear tight clothes outside, but when you come back home in the house, wear loose and comfortable clothes. At night also, when you sleep, your clothes should be really comfortable, and see to it that the air passage is clear. Your groin area, after all, breathes, and you should help to breathe. You should know that the skin at the groin area is breathing, and so wear loose, comfortable clothes. Fifth point, whenever you are wet, change your wet clothes immediately. Wet and sweaty clothes can cause excessive moisture, and that can lead to infection. I would simply suggest, during rainy season, better carry some spare clothing with you which are dry which you could change immediately. If you get wet by traveling, change the clothes after you reach your destination immediately. Even after workout, since you have sweated a lot, don't continue remaining wet. Change your clothes immediately after taking a shower. Sixth point, avoid scented products. There are many scented products available in the market which claim to balance the vaginal pH. They claim that they would make the area smell fresh and clean. But understand, these products will worsen the skin problems and aggravate the bacterial infection. Instead, clean the area with warm water and mild soap while bathing. If there is an infection in that area, then person should clean that area with warm water at least thrice in a day. Seventh point, yogasana. Now I'll share some yogasanas which are very effective to give a health to the vaginal area. I would suggest three very effective asanas. First, Viprit Karani. Second, Bhadrasana. And third, Setu Bandh Asana. These asanas will improve blood circulation in that area and keep the muscles flexible. Maintaining vaginal hygiene is so crucial, so important to keep that area healthy and strong and free from infection. Follow these simple tips to stay away from yeast infection and bacterial vaginosis. In case if you see certain symptoms like redness, itchiness, discharge, pimples, then attend to that immediately. Don't neglect these symptoms and follow these preventive techniques immediately. Life should be lived happily, in a relaxed way, in a peaceful way. Problems in this area can cause really irritative state, can cause depression, can cause lots of uneasiness. So be away from that and try and see that you live a happy, healthy and enthusiastic life. Namaskar.